Hello friends, I am Meenu Jain. In this video, I will discuss about 10 common questions on aeration tank in wastewater treatment plant. First question is, what is nutrient deficiency and why urea is dosed in aeration tank? Answer of this question is, nitrogen and phosphorus can be growth limiting if not present in sufficient amount in effluent wastewater. In general, a BOD to nitrogen to phosphorus weight ratio in wastewater treatment plant of 100 to 5 to 1 is needed for complete BOD removal and biological growth and health. For checking the nutrient deficiency, it is to be sure that at least 1 mg per liter or 1 ppm total inorganic nitrogen and 0.5 to 1 mg per liter orthophosphorus remains in the effluent at all times. If needed, nutrients should be dosed to incoming wastewater or aeration basin. Nitrogen source include anhydrous ammonia, urea, and ammonium salts. Both ammonia and nitrate are nitrogen sources for the growth. Phosphorus sources include phosphoric acid, disodium phosphate, and diammonium phosphate or DAP. Also, the nutrient addition rate should match the effluent BOD strength as much as possible. Next question is, why is sludge wasted? Sludge is wasted to maintain the desired mass of microorganism in the aeration tank. It is typically wasted when the actual mean cell residence time or MCRT or sludge age is higher than the target value. Typical secondary clarifiers at activated sludge plant thicken the activated sludge to 3 to 4 times the concentration in aeration tank. This can result in WAS MLSS concentration from 2000 to 10,000 mg per liter or 2000 to 10,000 ppm or 0.2 to 1% consistency. Next question is, what is the reason of dark black water with huge odor after an aeration and sludge is not settling in secondary tank thereafter? Answer of this question is, the black color is due to the shortage of oxygen. Less oxygen per unit, more organic load. Therefore, the organic load is increased in aeration tank. As a result, there is a shortage of oxygen in aeration tank. Thus, dissolved oxygen is declined, and this can be checked by measuring the DO in aeration tank, and DO should be about 1.5 to 2 mg per liter or ppm. For such type of problem, please check for malfunctioning of aeration system fault membranes. Second, cutting down the organic load of to aeration tank by reducing the flow or inlet BOD concentration or by adding more air into the aeration tank. Next, ensure that you are not dumping some chemicals like food preservative, detergent, oil or off-spec product in wastewater system, as this can increase the ATP load. It will take about 4 to 8 hours to restore if you balance the BOD load and oxygen supply, that is 1.5 kg oxygen per unit or per kg of BOD loading. Next question is, what is foaming or frothing in aeration tank? So, foaming and frothing is the condition describing a buildup of foam or froth on the surface of aeration tank. Causes of foaming and frothing are low MLSS, nutrient deficiency, solids recycled from dewatering processes, the presence of surfactants like detergent in the plant's effluent, over aeration, polymer overdosing, and growth of filamentous bacteria like nocardia. Nocardia foam is thick, dark brown foam that can be caused by a low FM ratio, high MLSS due to insufficient wasting and re-aerating activated sludge. Next question is, What are the various microorganisms present in aeration tank? The six basic groups of microorganisms are observed in activated sludge. Flagellates, amoeba, free swimming ciliates, attached stacked ciliates, rotifers, and invertebrates. Flagellates generally present in organic matter of high BOD system. Amoeba, this can grow well on particulate organic matter and can tolerate low dissolved oxygen. Free swimming ciliates, which found under condition of good flock formation and generally indicate good operation. Attached ciliates, these are found in low organic loading or low MCRT. Rotifers occurs in all and any condition, especially high MCRT. Higher invertebrates only observed in at higher MCRTs. Next question is, what are the various microbiological problems occurs in aeration tank? Most activated sludge upsets and loss of process control are caused by one of the several microorganism problems, which include poor flock formation, pin flock, dispersed growth, filamentous and slime bulking, filamentous forming, nitrification and denitrification problem, and toxicity. Once the causes of problem or upset is known, specific remedies appropriate for the problem can be used. Next question is, what is the reason of gray form in aeration tank of activated sludge process? A heavy dark skimming form is typically in plant that practical sludge re-aeration. The skimming dark form indicate an older sludge and can result in other problem downstream of aeration tank. There could also be presence of filamentous bacteria, nocardia in sludge. Next question is, what is the reason of white, frothy, blowing form in aeration tank of activated sludge process? So, stiff white blowing form indicate a young sludge or low MCRT. It is usually found in new plant or an overloaded plants. This means that the MLSS concentration is low and the FM ratio is high. Some probable causes of stiff white form include activated sludge not being returned to the aeration tank, low MLSS resulting from process startup, low MLSS for the current organic loading causes by excessive wasting of activated sludge or high organic load from an industry, most prominent during weekends. Next, the presence of unfavorable condition in activated sludge system, such as toxic conditions like pH below 6.5 or above 9, insufficient DO, nutrient deficiency, and seasonal temperature change are the major causes of this type of problem. Next question is, what is the reason of thick sludge blanket on final clarifier or secondary clarifier? Answer of this question is, cause of thick sludge blanket on the final clarifier or secondary clarifier is due to the denitrification in the clarifier. These type of forms are usually associated with plants operating at low loading range. Plants designed to nitrify or operating in nitrification mode will normally have low to moderate amount of dark brown form. Plants with filamentous organism nocardia will have a strong greasy dark tan form that will carry over onto the clarifier surface. Scum containing filamentous organism should be wasted from the system rather than returned to the aeration tank. A heavy dark brown greasy form is usually normal while operating in re-aeration mode of the operation. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please press thumbs up button And please don't forget to subscribe my channel, share this video to everyone, and write your suggestions in comment box below. Thank you.